Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO DVC Technology, and today I've got a great one. Today, I've got a little secret. This is my new favorite switch. I'm covering the new Switch Pro HD 24 PoE from Unifi, and this is one heck of a switch. So I'm gonna go through all the reasons that I truly love this switch, but spoiler alert, this may not be the right switch for you. Let's jump into the specs of this one, and let's discuss what gives this the HD name. So on this 24-port switch, we get 22 2.5 gigabit PoE++ ports. We also get two 10 gigabit PoE++ ports. 2.5 gigabits is the slowest port on this. There are no 1 gigabit ports on this, which is awesome, especially for high density installations. So we get four 10 gigabit SFP plus ports. We get DC power backup. We get 600 watts of total PoE availability. That's a huge budget for 24 ports. We also get etherlighting, which is cool. We get L3 switching support and Pro AV support. So this is a pretty big upgrade to the existing Pro Max 24 PoE, which I, you know, is a switch I really love. But the HD in the name obviously means that this is for high density installations where you're gonna have a ton of 2.5 gigabit connectivity and you need PoE++ in that 600 watt budget on a ton of items. What's also great about this is that it is the step between that Pro Max and the Enterprise Campus switches. You know, the Enterprise Campus switch is, you know, $2,400. This is significantly less expensive than that at $999. Now, obviously this is not an inexpensive switch at $999. I got this switch a while back and we threw it in the rack and I started playing with it and I realized really quickly, this is a super versatile switch. And actually, I pulled it out of the rack. I've been playing with this switch a ton. So obviously for me, for testing stuff, this is a great switch because it's got all this flexibility. I don't have to worry about, hey, does this port 1 gig and I really needed a 2.5 here? Or, you know, is this only got PoE plus? The budget, power budget with everything being PoE++ and everything being at least 2.5 gig is awesome. Also, you may have realized that the E7 WAP came out and it's got a 10 gigabit connection that needs PoE++. Well, this is the perfect switch for that solution. So for me, it's been super robust. I've been able to use it everywhere. It just powers everything. It is a hoss. It's awesome. What I really do like about this HD line though is it's below that enterprise campus kind of, you know, $2,500 and above price range. And also it's a step above those Pro Max switches that don't have 2.5 everywhere and they don't have the same power budget. So it's kind of, for me, it's kind of a Goldilocks spot. And I also think it's going to be a Goldilocks spot for a lot of small to medium sized businesses where they don't have the budget to spend, you know, $2,500 on a switch, but they want that 2.5 gigabit connectivity to future-proof themselves and the power budget to run everything with PoE++. So let's jump in the software real quick and I'll show you what it looks like. I didn't do a whole readoption on this unit because obviously if you're buying a $999 switch here, you know how to adopt it. And this is typically what I've been doing with it. You'll see I'm not doing anything super fancy. In fact, I don't even have it plugged into SFP plus ports right this at this point. I've got it on my bench and I've just got a regular uplink to it. But what I have been doing is testing a bunch of cameras. You'll see that I've done quite a few camera reviews lately and, you know, how do I test 40 cameras at once? Well, obviously I put them in switches. And the cool thing about this switch is I can just chunk a bunch of stuff on it and not really worry about connectivity. Now, right at this moment, I don't have anything really that's pushing this except for over here. This is the E7 WAP, which is on the two at the end down here are 10 gigabit. And you can see in the light blue, that is 10 gigabit. All right, now I'm not really pushing power consumption at all because I'm kind of in between setups here, but you can quickly see here in Port Manager, all the things that it can do. Obviously nothing super fancy or anything that's gonna blow your socks away. It's just a switch, but I can show it to you all the same. Basically you can manage it however you wanna manage it. It's really cool that it's got etherlighting. Basically the way I've been using this switch though is not the way that most people are probably gonna use it. I do not have it in the rack right now. It's actually up on a different workbench testing out some cameras. I've been doing some testing lately. I got the AI port. I've been playing around with every different camera. And it's really nice to be able to plug them all in at once and not have to worry about connectivity issues. Right now I don't have anything really that's pushing this at all, except for over here, I do have the E7 WAP in one of the 10 gigabit uplink ports. I think ultimately, once I'm done kind of playing with this switch, I will put it back in the rack. We're about to do a total refit of our rack in the server closet, and this one will probably go back there. Although I don't know, because I do really like this as my bench switch right now. This is replacing a Pro Max 24 PoE switch, which has been awesome. But I really do like the fact that I don't have to really manage or think about anything being 2.5 gigabit. And of course, as we're sitting here right now, I don't have anything that's 2.5 gigabit plugged into it. That's the way that YouTube works. So who do I think this is really for? Other than, you know, hobbyists that just want the latest, greatest, fastest stuff, or crazy YouTubers that do it because they can. I think this is the perfect device for a company like DVC Technology, where we have multiple 2.5 gigabit devices, maybe a 10 gigabit device, and we have PoE++. budgets that are going to push this. I think in the SMB space, to put this in as your PoE switch, if you need the 2.5 gigabit and you want to future-proof yourself that you're not going to need to upgrade it in the near future, I think this is a perfect switch. $999 is not oppressively expensive. It's expensive for a switch, but I think it's a pretty good value at that price for what this is providing for you. But I don't know, this switch may not be for everybody. Am I crazy for loving this $999 switch so much? Please put your comments down below. And as always, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.